Good afternoon friends, today we are going to discuss bottom-up parsing technique, that is the sheet-reduced parser. So what is sheet-reduced parser? It will sheet and reduce the productions or grammar with the help of stack and input buffer. So before going to discuss the concept of sheet-reduced parser, we will discuss the concept of bottom-up parsing. What is bottom-up parsing? Suppose we have a grammar, that is a key movie says CAD. So what we will try to do over here, we have this terminals CAD, these are the leaf node, and in bottom of parsing what we are going to do, we are going to reach at the our root node, that is E. Okay, so there are different four functions which are available in sheet reduced parser. First one is shift, second one is reduce, accept and error. So what is shift? As its name suggests, it will shift the particular input from input stack to the stack buffer. Reduce, what it will do? It will do the reduction of a right side sensorial form into the left side sensorial form. Suppose we take the example, CAD which are available at the right side sensorial form, what we will do in a reduction? We will do CAD which is reduced by the our top terminal node or top non-terminal node, that is E. Except if the input buffer whole string which is to be scanned by the sheet reduced parser, at that time accept is generated. If accept is not generated, then what we will do? What will generate? It will generate the error, and that error which is to be transferred or forwarded to the error handler. Now we will discuss this thing, that is shift, reduce and accept and error, whether it is performed practically or not. We will take this example, E produces or E extract E plus E or E extract E star E. Next, E produces E ID. So, and our input string is, ID1 plus ID2 star ID3. So, what we have to do? We have our terminal node or leaf node, that is ID1 to ID3, and with the help of that, we have to reach at our top node. Here, just like CAD to E, so here we have to reach from our leaf node to the top node. Okay, so here we have stack, input and action. First action, that is serial number 1. Stack, that is always started with dollar symbol, which shows that there is no any production which are available, and in input buffer that input is always ended with dollar symbol, which shows that end of file. Now ID1 plus ID2 star ID3, we have put this input into input buffer. First action, that is shift. What we have to do? We have to shift input into stack. So here in second instruction, what we have to do? Dollar ID1. So here what will be remain? Plus ID2 star ID3. Now ID1 is reduced to E. We know that this thing are already discussed in grammar, already available in grammar. So reduce ID into E. Okay, so here we will write dollar E. Okay, ID1 is reduced to dollar E. Now what will be remain over here? Same, plus ID2 star ID3. But next instruction is, next function is shift. So what we have to shift? Plus is shifted to stack. Okay, so what will be there? Stack dollar E plus, and input buffer there is ID1 star ID3. Now in grammar there is no any reduction which are available for plus symbol, so we will go for the next, that is shifting of next symbol, that is ID2. In stack we are going to shift E plus ID2. ID2 is shifted to the stack. Now we know that in grammar id to also reduce to e, so here we will apply the next function, that is reduce id to e. So instead, which is what we will remain over here, plus dollar e plus e. Okay, in input buffer what it will remain here, star id3 and dollar. So next function which what we are going to apply, we are going to apply shift. Okay, so this shift function shift a star into stack from input buffer to stack. Now next one, what will be remain over here, dollar e plus e star, and here what it will remain, id3 dollar. But in grammar we know that there is no any production which is available for reduction to id1 to e and star to e, so we will perform nothing for this. Now next, we are going for next shift function. Here we are going to shift it id3 into stack, okay, top of the stack. So here we know that id is reduced to e, so we will apply the next function, that is reduce e to id. Okay, so here we are going to reduce e plus e e. Okay, now what we will remain over here, in input buffer there is no any symbol are available. So here the meaning is that whether the whole thing is scanned, yes whole thing is scanned, but the whole production is not till now scanned. Okay, so what we will do, we are going to reduce next production which are available in stack. So we are going to reduce e plus e e star e. So what we are going to reduce e star e, why? Because bottom up parsing always use the concept of right most derivation. Here we are going to scan whole input stream, but whenever reduction is applied at that time, we are going to use the concept of right most derivation. And in grammar we know that e star e is reduced to root node, that is e. So here we are going to next reduce function, that is e star e reduced to e. So here we will have e plus e. Now in stack we have e plus e, and we know that e plus is reduced to e. So what is this? E plus e is reduced to e, and in now stack top is contained dollar e, and input is contained dollar, that is nothing is available, and stack is describe our starting node. We are already discussed at the starting of this lecture. That is what we are going to try in shift reduce parsing. We are going to reach at our root node. So this is our root node, and here we are going to declare the accept. Okay, so these are the things which are related to the shift reduce parser. But what is the problem which are available in shift reduce parser? The shift reduce parser, the conflict which are available, whether we have to shift or whether we have to reduce. Okay, suppose id1 is reduced to e. So what we have to do? We have to reduce it, or we have to go for the next input symbol. So these are the few conflicts or problems which are available in shift reduce parser, which can be overcome by LRP technique. That these are the things we will discuss in upcoming lecture.